DJ Podcast. My name is David James. This one's going to be an interesting one. It's going to bring in to the podcast the alien extraterrestrial. Humans are the sixth hybrid race of the Greys. They are our future. They what we evolve into in the future. There's a bunch of concepts that I've talked about in the previous episodes. One of them that's important for this one is everything is happening here and now. Multiple universes, aliens. I mean, we need to bring it all together here. This whole time I've been talking about Bashar, who's an extraterrestrial channeling through Daryl Anka, and we're gonna kind of get into that. And I don't know. Hopefully you like it. I like it. First things first, we kind of just need to set a base where I think it's unbelievably impossible that we are the only intelligent beings out there. You know, we see the sightings, UFO sightings. We see the alien spacecraft. You know, that's what it's claimed to be, anyways. Recently, the government announced non-human biologics were found at the Area 51 crash and stuff like that. Like they basically admitted that the Area 51 has non-human biologics. I'm going to use their terminology just so I don't kind of misquote it. So it goes into this podcast then is, well, if you don't have the belief in extraterrestrials and aliens, it's going to be one that you just kind of okay, Dave, whatever. But I just look at the size of our solar system, the size of our galaxy, the size of other galaxies, and we know that space is just rapidly expanding out and becoming bigger and bigger all the time. And it's in my mind, it's kind of hard to think that there aren't parallel universes. You know, there aren't at least minimum super intelligent beings that can travel from one end of the universe to the other. And I'm even going to get a little bit into how the little gray men are artificially intelligent AI robots, biological, almost like consciousness. They have full consciousness AI. It's a full conscious AI that doesn't age, which is important when you're trying to do dimensional time changes to have creatures that don't age. So all right, let's kind of get into it. We're gonna put down a quote here by Bashar, and the people on YouTube are going to see me going through the computer and putting it down, and then hopefully we'll have it where it's synced up with the audio and stuff like that. Maybe I can pause it here.
Hatu Bashar.
And who you Hatu?
I remember in the Esasani story, Holotope Meditation, you spoke about the six hybrid races.
Five? You being what's becoming the sixth.
Okay.
Five that already exist, one in transition.
Okay, thank you. Five, and over a period of 1,000 years, them coming together and creating a seventh hybrid race, a new race.
Yes.
Can you share with us those five hybrid races and the events that will take place over the 1,000 years, some of them, and a little bit about the seventh race?
We are, of course, one of the hybrid races. The beings we have referred to as the Shalanaya that call themselves the Yael, which will be the first hybrid race to make contact with your planet in terms of an open contact forum are another one. There are three more worlds of hybrid beings. We are not allowed to discuss much about them at this time. The idea, of course, is that you are becoming the sixth hybrid being, species, planet in that sense, and it will be an admixture eventually of the humans you are now and the hybrids that will ultimately, as children, wind up on your planet, creating more and more and more of, in that sense, an interblending of DNA. Thus then, all together eventually, over the course of the balancing of your world and the expressions of your world, over the next 1,000 years, you, in a sense, will be joining what we call the Association of Worlds, and you will also undertake your own interactions with other worlds, becoming their guides, becoming their UFOs. And in that sense, uplifting them in a certain way. And as you do this, and as you explore an adventure out into the stars with us, you will thus then, in joining with us, help create in a very specific way a new seventh hybrid race that is something that will exist in another dimensional plane altogether, that will be like the expression of an oversoul, in a sense, of all the other six hybrid races.
Thank you very much. I appreciate your...
So that's a quote from Bashar, and part of a clip from an interview, because he does the shows. I don't know if he still does them or not. I would assume that Daryl Inkle still does it to this day. anyways, that's like a quick overview of like what humans, where maybe humans could have come from, right? I think a lot of people might hear that and go, wow, that's kind of far-fetched out there, Dave. But when you really think about it, what he's basically saying is that we are evolving in this parallel universe. See, there's something you have to realize, is that all the parallel universes are happening right now. Think of it as an infinite number of timelines happening right now. And what happened is, it's kind of hard to believe this, is that there was a version of humans that destroyed the planet Earth. Became super highly advanced technologically, and then somehow found a way to not reproduce because of weird bad experiments gone wrong. Cloning failed. It's if you follow Bashar, you know he does give the like whole breakdown of it, and you can find large clips explaining like the whole thing. But anyways, so basically we're on a timeline here where humans are going to evolve and shift their frequencies towards the more positive side of within 1,000 years, we're going to evolve into the grays, and then we're going to have some of the same choices that we already had to kind of fork off into a different direction of a hybrid race of humans that kind of make it through instead of somehow find a way to fall to their demise and have to tunnel their way it back into a parallel universe where humans are still producing viable DNA. And you would say to yourself, well, how is all this possible, and why doesn't it just repeat? Well, one of the reasons why we don't have like the butterfly effect and things like that in this reality is that each decision we make branches off in two different directions and forms another parallel universe. Especially decisions that are made as a collective, as a whole. And right now, what's happening to you is that your physical reality is a simulation or it's really just you perceiving this current physical reality. And that's in other podcasts I talk about raising and lowering your frequency. So you can perceive things at a higher frequency and a higher vibration than you, and thus hopefully split off into the you want to go towards the positive side of the Earth splitting into a different parallel universe. And we're actually coming up to a point right now. It is said that with all these more UFO sightings that we've been seeing and all the stuff, that we're actually going to get to a major contact event that's coming in the next decade or so here. And there's going to be a moment where the Earth splits off into two different parallel universes. One's going to be a dystopia and one's going to be a topia, right? It's going to be positive versus negative. That's why we're seeing a lot of splits in our politics, a lot of splits in general knowledge. You know, we have a lot of people who debate flat earthers and stuff like that. A lot of people debating all the natural science that we know. It's going to be are we shifting towards Idiocracy, that movie about really smart people who choose not to have children versus really dumb people who choose to have children. It's a great comedy. And it feels like our universe or our reality is shifting towards it's shifting towards like the dumber version of Earth. But really we're seeing, if you're a person who's on this spiritual path, if you're a person who believes in the frequencies and the vibrations, your soul being divine, your soul being part of the source, all these things I've been saying, the all is the one is the all, you know, we're all part of the same creator, the creator being energy, source, it's being that one thing. Like I said, you know, we're kind of getting deeper into the podcast episodes, and if you're not 100% what I'm talking about, you have to go back and listen to some of those episodes. But anyways, it's all coming down to where humans, you got the non-believers of aliens, and you got the believers of aliens. And you got the believers of evolution and the non-believers of evolution, and you have people that don't explore their whole self, right? I mean, if you're not exploring your spiritual side, if you're not exploring your higher self, if you're not exploring your soul, then you're not really experiencing the entire you. Because you have to remember, there's the physical version of you and there's the non-physical version of you. The non-physical version of you being your soul. And your soul lives in a fifth dimensional realm. It lives on forever. It exists forever, and it experiences. What your soul does is it experiences multiple lives in multiple dimensions and multiple versions of Earth and maybe other planets. Maybe the future self of you is actually one of these hybrid grays. The grays being the gray, big black-eyed gray aliens, you know, that we evolve into them. They're distant relevance of ours. And they exist, they currently exist in another dimension. So I'm going to put in another quote that kind of just goes into who the grays are in particular.
I was wondering what you could tell us about them. Are they harmful, sinister? Are they part of an interstellar alliance?
My goodness.
Yeah.
the ones that we have addressed, and first and foremost, let me remind all of you, there are actually many different types of grays. Mm. You can't actually just lump them all into one particular type.
Oh, okay.
Though we know many of you do, and that can be what causes a lot of confusion in you when you see different kinds of behaviors. Do you understand?
Yes.
But the ones that are most relevant, you have to understand that the story of the grays is really that they began on a parallel Earth as humans. And they destroyed their world and they mutated into the form you call the grays. And they did it in such a way that they could no longer reproduce. So in order to perpetuate their civilization, they had to tunnel into parallel realities where humans still existed with viable human DNA. And use that DNA in order to create hybrid beings such as ourselves, which would allow their culture to continue. So in a sense, a gray is actually just a form of mutated human. Do you understand?
I do.
And by using their example as a lesson, your world doesn't necessarily have to go down the same destructive path. You follow me?
I do. This is going to segue great into another question.
Why, thank you for your synchronicity.
So my next question...
And for me, that... once again, that's a quote, bizarre quote. And for me, it makes sense. It makes sense that humans of today would find a way to destroy themselves, become very technologically advanced, somehow figure out a way to not be able to reproduce, not be able to protect their own species, and in the nick of time, invent a time machine or the flying saucers that we see. And at the all same time, invent artificial intelligence with consciousness. It's said that the little grays, there's little grays and tall and big grays or tall grays. The little grays are said to be artificially intelligent species that was created to pilot these flying saucers. And they the reason being is that the flying saucers, the UFOs that have been reverse engineered, okay? Because these currently there's people who have these UFOs and they're trying to reverse engineer them and of course use them probably it's going to start off military and stuff like that. But they're controlled by consciousness. So as we get better with AI, it is said that our AI technology will be controlled with their consciousness. And that's why when we see these spacecrafts reverse engineered, they're always described as being like no control panels, no obvious way to control or function these things. It's because they're literally hooking these up to their consciousness, their brain. And these grays, the little grays, are the pilots who don't age, so they are non-biological, but they have consciousness and artificial intelligence, super advanced artificial intelligence. And it's important that they don't age because they're parallel time jumping using the alien crafts. So the UFOs are time machines. That is what a time machine is. It's something that can travel through different dimensions, different timelines. It can go from a future timeline of this current timeline. It can go to a past timeline of this timeline. And no, they're not meant to rearrange time so this really bad event doesn't happen. But they are allowed to change how we handle ourselves so that a negative timeline doesn't happen. Now, when huge events happen, that's usually a split. That's usually a split of positive vibrations and negative vibrations. There's a parallel universe where 9/11 didn't happen. right? There's a parallel universe where it went worse than it did. But we're living this timeline. We're living in this universe. And that's the one that we experience. But without us, hey, catching on to all this negativity and a whole bunch of us going, you know what, we're gonna be positive through this whole thing. We're gonna raise our frequency. We're gonna raise our vibration. And with no matter what happens in life, we stay positive and we become higher beings of ourselves. We become almost like we evolve into our souls. That's one way I've seen it in some visions I had in what I call the dream at this point. But I've changed it to a vision. The vision of me seeing myself evolving into my soul, into my higher self. So basically my belief is that we evolve into these higher hybrid races, these more advanced hybrid races. There will be multiple splits of our universe where you want to be, in my opinion anyway, you want to be on the train that's going to the higher frequency. You want to be on the train that's leading to a better future. You want to be on the train that's leading to a better humanity, a better race, a better species. Right? I see so many people these days arguing about global warming, arguing about all these dumb things, gender identities and stuff like that. All these really dumb arguments where humans are divided. We're divided on these things. Like I've said to people that all humans should be allowed to have no human should go hungry, basically. No human should not have shelter, food, clean water, clean air, a safe environment, healthcare, education. All these things could be paid for, in my mind. There are multi-billionaires on this planet, and then there's starving people. There's people in the streets. We spend millions and billions of dollars on wars, the war in Afghanistan, the war in Ukraine, and in general I supporting Ukraine. But at the same time, I think to myself, if we can put all this money to supporting Ukraine, why don't we put this money into supporting United States citizens? Why don't we put money into education, healthcare, solving the homeless problem, solving food problems, solving the energy problems? Why don't we do that as a society? And it's because we are surrounded by negative vibration. But if you notice that on all these topics, you know, changing to renewable energy, changing cars to electric cars, the Flint, Michigan still has bad water, this and that, that and this. With all these topics, there is a lot of times a clear line drawn in the sand of what side, what political aisle you're on, what's viewpoints of this and that. Right, all these things are very clear lines drawn in the sand. So to me, that's obvious. As a collective, some people think we could become a better human race, and some people think that our human race is doomed. I think we could become a better human race. I actually have some faith in humanity, and for me, it's because I walk around and I talk to people about this spirituality, and I throw these ideas out there. I throw these ideas of your soul being divine, meaning you're part of the first creator. If you're part of the first creator, you're part of creation, and being part of creation means that you exist. by definition, you exist, because non-existence doesn't exist. Like, I believe in that. I believe in the all and the all in the one. I believe that every representation of the all, or God, every representation of the all is representing the same thing. It's all representing the all. So whether you're looking at a Buddhist statue, a Jewish thing, a Christianity thing, a Hindu thing, it doesn't matter. A Muslim, any religion. It's all representing the same religion. It's all representing all, the all, the source. It's the same thing that our souls are connected to. It's where our souls have been created from. It's why I call humans divine. We are part of divinity, because we have been created by God. We have been created by the all. So that means that you are, it's kind of like they say, you're God's children. So that means that you are part divine. You're part of the creation. And then it's up to you to live your life. We do have free will. We have choices. We have moral codes that we live by. It's up to you in your life to determine which direction I'm going to take this. I'm either going to take this and be the best you, the best me I can be, the best you can be, however you want to say it. We have choices to always be doing your greatest passion, your greatest desire. It's whatever thing in that moment it seems like the most fun thing to do in that moment. Not fun. Fun, it could be fun, but it's your excitement. It's often caused your excitement. It raises your vibration. Raising your vibration, raising your frequency, staying with your passions, just doing what you are passionate about with the available sources around you, doing those passions and totally exploring your soul, exploring your highest self, exploring who you are, raising your frequency and all that. Well, when the big dimensional shift happens, you're going to be either on the positive train or on the negative train. We're either heading towards becoming the sixth hybrid race and a super intelligent hybrid extraterrestrial being. Well, it's not really extraterrestrial. They come from this planet, right? We either become that awesome race of hybrid humans, or we destroy ourselves. And that's kind of, to me, it makes sense. It's what I believe in. I believe that that's kind of where we're heading. And ultimately, it's up to us to decide which way we're going, which way we're doing. Are you going to follow your highest passion, raise your frequency, live in the reality that you prefer to live in, manifest the power of attraction, manifest the reality that you want to be in, raise your frequency, raise your vibration, And that is your impact on the world. It's making sure that the human race, when we split off, we go into the positive direction. We become people who are less selfish. We become people who have less mindism thoughts. Mind. We start to look at our entire race and say, look, we don't need the system that we have now, because the system we have now leaves people behind. It has homeless people. It has people who can't get medical care. People who doesn't have access to heat, shelter. People who doesn't have food and things to survive. Things that are needed for our human race to survive. Our human race to become interdimensional time-traveling beings, right? when we care more about the billionaire having their life standards met 1,000%, and we don't care about the people at the bottom. We don't care about the actual hard workers who build this society, the people who get up every single day and have an impact on what happens to people in their everyday lives, right? The people who are out there doing the construction, the infrastructure of the society, the firefighters, the policemen, the people who are actually out there fighting for justice and doing the job correctly. The people who, the nurses, everyone, the people who take care of the elderly, all these people, straight down to the burger flippers, the coffee makers, the people that help us function through society. Think about it. If these people were gone, if all of a sudden you woke up tomorrow and none of the fast food restaurants had coffee and all of these luxuries, warm breakfast sandwiches, all these luxuries that we get so used to, if our roads weren't built, if this and that, right? The people, not the giant corporations at the top, where one person benefits from all of our hard work, but the people at the bottom benefit from all their hard work. Bashar always talks about synchronicity, having things synchronize up, having information there when you need it, having supplies there when you need it, having the ability to do what you need to do when you need to do it and how you need to do it. It's supporting the collective. It's supporting the race. That's what it's about. And don't fear aliens coming down and taking over this planet. The super smart, intelligent beings don't destroy really good planets. Super smart, intelligent beings don't come and wipe out entire civilizations. They don't come and genocide entire civilizations. They work together. They learn together. They become better together. They come better together as a whole. Okay? They're not worried about race, skin color, sexuality. They realize that our souls are genderless, raceless. It's not as black and white as we think it is. It's not, everything's a spectrum. Everything's from A to Z. It's not A and B, it's A to Z. It's something humans have to realize, is that there's one human race. And why we're not working together to make this human race the best human race we can be, why we, when we see people with dirty water in a first world country that has millions and billions of dollars and spends billions of dollars going to war, can't get clean water to all of its citizens. It's coming together and looking at these things and saying, we want to be better as a collective. We want to be better as a whole. We want what's best for the race, not what's best for one. It's what's best for the race, best for the collective. And in general, if we worry about what's best for the collective, then that means that the individuals are taken care of. Then what is best for the collective also becomes a benefit for the whole, or for the individual, for the one, for the singular. And it's something that we have to realize. When we take care of the bottom, the top will come with too. Right? It's something that we have to start understanding. We have to start listening to people. People who say, look in the mirror. Take a look in the mirror and determine that, are you treating others how you actually want to be treated? Are you a leader like Jesus? Jesus wanted you to be a leader. Matter of fact, they say that the second coming of Christ is you becoming Christ-like. You doing as Jesus would do. He fed the homeless. He fed the hungry. He turned a dozen fish into enough to feed hundreds. You know what I'm saying? It's all these miracles that we speak about. become the leader, become the person that has passion, become the person who has great perspective on life. You know, leaders like Jesus and Buddha and all these people, Gandhi, all these people who are at a higher vibration than all of us, trying to show us the way, and then what have we done? You know, we tortured them. We took them down. Instead of becoming the leader and doing what's best for the collective, doing what's best for the whole, we shunned them down to gain personal power. That's what happened. Think about it. It's crazy. So going on forward, I will probably do more episodes that describe the grays, describe the tall grays, the little grays, all this stuff. And I'll try and become very detailed in it. But for now, it's going to be kind of light until I have a greater understanding, because I don't like to share things on my podcast that I don't feel like I have a great understanding, or at least the greatest understanding that I can have on it. So that's kind of my truth to you. My promise to you, I'm always going to give you the best information that I have available to me at the time. Right? That's something I try to do with this podcast. I try and analyze it as logically as possible. All these Bashar quotes. And boy, when you hear them and watch them speak, you can see them on YouTube and TikTok and all these social, you really think to yourself, boy, what he is saying just feels so real. You know, it feels, he has so much confidence in his voice. He has so much power and emphasis and passion. And it's like, how could it not be real? And I do try and check myself and try and go, hey, is this a cult, or is this something weird? Like why do I like this so much? And it's like, and then it's weird. I'm doing these podcasts, and even last time I was trying to record a similar episode to this one. All of a sudden I had this vision that my brain is an antenna. It's an antenna talking to my soul. My soul needs a way to communicate with me, and it communicates through the pineal gland, the third eye in your brain. It's that's the soul connection part of your brain. Your soul has independent thought to think of things here on earth, but it also has the ability to listen into your soul, to listen into your consciousness, and be guided by your soul and by your consciousness. It has the ability to say, I'm the highest self. I'm going to try and guide you towards this great moment. Raise your frequency. Start listening to me. Start meditation. Start believing in yourself. Start doing the inner work. You know, cleaning up your shadow self. You know, like I'm reading this, the inner workbook that I started telling you about. I'm reading that, and I'm finding a lot of really interesting things about myself. It's all real positive. It's all real straightforward. And once you start to believe in it, once you start to believe in your higher self, all of a sudden these things around you start coming together. It helps you make decisions. It helps you you just decide what you're going to do for the day. It helps you make bigger decisions in your life. It helps you to connect with your higher self. It helps you connect with your soul so you can be all of you, so you can be your entire self. Your physical self and your non-physical self coming together, that's the divinity. That's the divinity. It's your soul, your energy. The part that's connected to source, connected to God, God being the all in the one, right? The whole, the entirety. When you realize that you're connected to that, and you're in the real meaning of life is whatever you want the meaning of life to be. That is the speciality of meaning of life. We have free will. We get to choose our own meaning of life. And when you come together as a collective, you'll start seeing all these positive things start coming through your life. And there we have it. I think that's a good one. You know, that's the podcast I've been looking for a while, to just sit down and kind of sort of explain the grays and how I see the human race is slowly evolving towards becoming the sixth hybrid race, and I want to be part of it. I hope it's the timeline that my higher self chose for me. Is this Earth timeline? I want to see it finish out, and I'm going to be able to see it through my multiple lives. I'm currently living this multiple life, or this life, in this frequency, on this planet, in this reality. It's the one I'm living through. I'm hoping I can raise my frequency to then experience my next life. I'm hoping I can continue on this path. I could become a super Dave. I could become my highest self. I could become my best self. And how do I do that? I follow my greatest passions. I follow my greatest excitements. I do what I can with this part of my life, and I leave it better than I came into it. And that's a great goal in life. That really is. Anyways, DJ Podcast. Hopefully you enjoyed this one, and I'm going to set you up with some more meditation sounds.